the invisible enemy that is COVID-19 has brought about an unfamiliar global landscape and unleashed a crisis without precedent. It is the biggest test the world and the United Nations face since World War II. While the United Nations has brought relief and hope to so many countries and peoples around the world, it now finds itself saddled by a virus that has taken many lives and wrecked economies and social order. We are at a crossroads. How we address COVID-19 will define our future. For the Philippines, this means putting up all of the peoples of our United Nations at the core of this response. We will need to ask hard and fundamental questions about the vision and mission that the United Nations conceptualized 75 years ago. We need to ask ourselves whether or not we have remained true and faithful to the United Nations principles and ideas. Mr. President, in the light of the realities of the present, the Philippines grieves with all of the families all over the world who lost their loved ones to this horrible virus. We extend our heartfelt condolences. We salute all frontliners who put up their lives on the line even in countries not their own. So also do we honor and recognize the healthcare professionals who selflessly answered the call and to combat the COVID-19 pandemic despite its virulence and unknown characteristics. While each nation has its own strategy in fighting the pandemic, what the world needs are coordinated international plans and efforts to pursue a common purpose. COVID-19 knows no border, it knows no nationality, it knows no race, it knows no gender, it knows no age, it knows no creed. The Philippines values the role that the United Nations plays in its fight against the pandemic. And a middle-income country whose economic advantages have been derailed by the pandemic, we welcome the launch of the UN COVID Response and Recovery Fund. Ensuring universal access to anti-COVID-19 technologies and products is pivotal in the global pandemic recovery. The world is in the race to find safe and effective vaccine. When the world finds that vaccine, access to it must not be denied nor withheld. It should be made available to all rich and poor nations alike as a matter of policy. The Philippines joins our partners in the ASEAN and the non-aligned movement and in raising our collective voice. The COVID-19 vaccine must be considered a global public good. Let us be clear on this.